everybody. Janet Watson Art Designs in Nature. How are you today? It's a beautiful Saturday, sun's shining, it's lovely, and I'm here and I'm going to be cooking some eggy bread. And I have a numerous amount of fillings, which is really cool. Today I am going to cook eggy bread with different fillings. So I have my setup here all around me with my gas behind me. And so I'll just run through it. So for start off, we have the eggs, beautiful, nice dark brown eggs, lovely. And then we have bacon and maple syrup for one of the toppings. Then we have ham and cheese for another topping. Then we have tomato, feta cheese and dill. And here we have blueberries and bananas. Here we have some cinnamon to go in the eggy mixture. And here we have some beautiful cream cheese with garlic and herbs in, and strawberries. And here we have some lovely apples, which I'll be cooking those down. cooking those down in a bit of water and a bit of sugar here. And that'll be like a syrup on top of the eggy bread. I have my bread here, and it's giraffe bread rather than tiger bread. It's the first time I've heard of giraffe bread. And I have my milk, and because it's breakfast, I thought, right, I'll have some orange juice. So I'm just going to pour myself some orange juice. Well deserved. Oh, and have some oil as well. And some butter. Cheers, everybody. I needed that. Right, so in this bowl, I'm going to put bit of milk. And in goes my cinnamon. And now I'm just going to, I haven't got a whisk, so I've got a fork. Oops. I like cinnamon. So how I'm going to do this is I'm going to cook the bread first and pop it on the plate. So now I'm going to light the gas. So I don't know if I'm going to do this straight away. Oh, it's stuck. Oh, hang on. Right, let's try again. So now I'm going to light the gas. There we go. I don't know if you can see that. You can see the flame from my match. Hopefully. So what I'm going to do now, she says. Start again. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put some butter in the frying pan with some oil. And I'm going to let that warm up so that I can then start the bread. So the butter is and the oil is bubbling well. So now to dip some of the bread in the egg mixture and start frying. So I'll start frying each side. So here's the bread. So I'll just dip it nicely in the egg. Then pop it in the frying pan. Just turn it up a little bit more, and then I'll cook it on both sides, and then I'll place it on this plate, and I'll do a few, and then it'll be ready for the fillings, the stages of the fillings. Smells gorgeous. It's lovely. I love cinnamon as well. Absolutely gorgeous. I have read in some recipes that you can use brioche bread, or you're supposed to use brioche bread, because this is a French dish, I think, and brioche is French, French bread. So I just went to the store and just bought this bread. So really it doesn't really matter, I suppose. No offence. Oh, it smells beautiful. That's really nice. In this pan I've just put some oil, and I'm just going to put some butter in, and apparently the butter stops it from burning, which is good. So I've seen it smoke. Oh, there we go. So in here I'm just gently going to fry tomatoes and the dill and the feta cheese, and that will be going on one of the toasts. So in that goes, and that's what it looks like there. So I'm just going to gently warm that up. And in the meantime, I'll put one of my toasts in there. You can hear it sizzling, very nice. So that's lovely, that's done. So now I'm going to pour it onto my toast. Pour it. It is poured. So that's what that looks like. It's beautiful. It smells lovely. And then another one. I'm going to put one of the toasts in there. I actually haven't brought enough plates and bowls and stuff, so I'm going to have to make do in a minute. So now this next one I'm going to just put on the So I'm just going to put on the cream cheese and the strawberries on there. So there we go, and that looks lovely. And then this one, I'm just going to pop on the banana and blueberries, and they are just going to go nicely on top of there. Oops. And that's that one, that looks very nice. Hello everybody, just wanted to show you this. I'm making a syrup for the apples. So in here I have a couple of teaspoons of sugar, a little bit of water and some butter, and I'm just going to warm that through. Find my gloves. Because this handle is going to be hot. So the butter and the sugar's melting. I have done it a different way to other people on the internet because I didn't want my pans to burn. I know the butter is meant to stop that or help stop that, but I thought it's the same ingredients, so we'll give it a go. So I just need it to glaze and cook down the apples. So I'm just going to put those in now. So we'll let the butter melt and the water boil so that it will become a syrup for the apples, and the apples will soften up then. So I've turned up the gas to make it nice. I have icing sugar to sprinkle on the eggy bread with the apples. I do need to cook another bread, another two actually, because I have bacon as well. I'm doing a lot today. Well everybody, this one that I'm doing now is the ham and cheese. So to make it nice, warm up the ham and the cheese so it melts on top. So I'll just put the ham on that, and the cheese, it's broken up a bit unfortunately. I bought the slices that you can just buy, because I thought it might be a good idea, but it's broken up a little bit. Let's try and get that on there. There we go. So that will melt, hopefully, the cheese and ham will be just so nice on the eggy bread. Oh dear me, I've been very adventurous today. I'm cooking lots. I still haven't cooked the bacon. So the next one, which is this one here, I'm going to put the bacon on that one and drizzle it with maple syrup. The apples, gotta look creepy cool. The apples are on here, I don't know if you can see that, I'll put that on there. So I'm going to take this off so that I can actually start to cook the bacon. Because I know that as soon as it goes dark, as soon as it starts to get dark, it will just go dark really quick. And I don't want to be out here in the dark, because I'm not camping out here. So I'm just cooking. So I'm just going to put it here. And I'm hoping you can see, so I've got the icing sugar here, so I'm just going to sprinkle some of that on top there. I don't have a sieve, that's what it's not from the oven here. I came a bit later, so it's later than breakfast, so this is sort of brunch, which is a bit like lunch. Oh, this bacon smells lovely. Oh, it's beautiful. I brought smoked bacon. It's lovely. I'm hoping you can see everything. I need to organise my camera and maybe have another camera facing as well. But I only have the one camera. So. Right, I'll leave that to cook for a bit and I'll be back in a minute. Bye for now. It just is taking a little bit of time. So my gas is still running, I'm still there. It's just very slow. I have turned it up, so I'm not sure. About done. So I'll now pop that onto the Eggy Bread. And I will now pop on some maple syrup. Lovely. How about that? What a meal. Oh, have I done that right? I'm just trying to shut this off completely. I think I've done it right. And there we have it. Looking absolutely gorgeous. Can't wait to tuck in. So here we have the strawberries and cream cheese with garlic and herbs on the Eggy Bread. Here we have Eggy Bread with tomatoes and feta cheese and dill, and they were slightly warmed up, fried in the frying pan. Here we have blueberries and bananas with the icing sugar on. Here we have bacon on the Eggy Bread with maple syrup. Here we have ham and cheese, and here we have the lovely apple on the Eggy Bread that has been cooked in sugary syrup and butter. Absolutely glorious. Very nice. Back in a bit. Hello everybody. Now I'm going to tuck in. That's lovely. The flavours are gorgeous. Rather a lot to get through. Well, everybody, it's goodbye for me for today, for another filming, another cooking. As you can see, leave without a trace, which is brilliant, and everybody needs to do that. So after all, it is nature, and it's cool. I've really enjoyed my day here. And I look forward to the next one. So see you again soon. Bye for now.